sorry for the lies. I'm sorry for the lies. I'm sorry for everything that happened here. I went to prison for half of my life, so I think I've more than paid for it, okay?
You were sent to prison. You have to take responsibility for that.
Hi, I'm Sandra Bullock.
And I'm Nora Fingscheidt.
And we're going to take you through a scene in The Unforgivable, shot by shot.
Oh my God, I said I did it. Can you just tell me where John is?
John would tell you exactly what I'm telling you right now, okay? You lost your opportunity. Lost it.
In the story, so Ruth just heard from Katie's sister that Katie's playing a piano rehearsal, and she knows that this is her only chance of seeing Katie, but she also knows that she is legally not allowed to come close to Katie. So she doesn't want to mess it up this time, and she tries to reach John Ingram. She cannot, so she goes there a second time, entering the Ingram space.
John looks at you and he sees someone who deserves a second chance. I don't see that. I hear someone who will say anything to get what she wants.
You would do exactly the same thing for
no,
your kids.
Oh, no, don't go
exactly.
there. Don't I even pretend this is about her.
Exactly, I was protecting her.
Well, this was a scene that we shot on the second day of coming back after COVID. And I know, I mean, there were reasons in the schedule that we had to film in that way. But it was super scary, at least for me.
But I remember this day so hard to not be closer to Viola, that I had to stay away, that I wanted to always move into her space, and I couldn't, which in turn I think reads well that it's like a caged animal. Like, I wanted to be up in her space, but COVID was going, get back. But the thing that I was so moved by was that Viola had come out of the house a couple times and then asked for the boys to come back so the boys could be passing by her so she could tell them to go inside. So that feeling of protecting your children could ignite her performance. And the difference of just those boys walking by her and her coming out of that house, she came out with a fire and venom that only a mother could have.
You are not a victim!
I said all right?
I That's
did
bullshit.
It! I had to make
Face
a choice!
It. You traumatized her. Do not
I
even
fucking said I did
this
it!
This is about her!
She was only 5 years old! She was only 5 years old!
With this scene, the whole movie stands or falls.
Yeah.
Like, there is not a single line that we haven't questioned 100 times. And then we did a kind of a reading, not a real rehearsal, but more like an on-set reading the day before, which is always great. I love that, to explore the space a little bit, and then we can all sleep over it. But then on the day, we didn't rehearse it anymore. Because, I mean, at some point with those emotions, you know you don't have a lot of takes. And, you know, this scene leads to the truth revealing for the first time, probably after 20 years, of what really happened.
Where are you going? How many times do I gotta tell you? You come to that door and I swear to fucking God, we are not leaving! We are not leaving!
I remember, you know, the day on set that we started with Sandy's takes, and after the second take, I remember that our sound supervisor, sound man on set, he came to me and he said, "Nora, I have to tell you something. I'm doing this job since 25 years, and I never cried on set until today." But that was the moment that I felt like, wow, you know, Sandy just created something so truthful and so powerful and so emotional here. It's a scene, it means a lot to me.
You are not a victim!
I said
that's bullshit!
Here is this white woman who gets out after prison, after 20 years having caused so much pain. And if it had been the reverse, Viola having done this, do we honestly think that society would allow her out of prison after 20 years? We know what that answer is. It's not an easy subject to talk about, but we have to talk about it. So her saying, "You are not a victim," you just play that line and you feel it in every pore of your body. That's the power of Viola Davis.
Here's my phone.
did it.
We really hope you enjoyed the inside look at the film.
Watch The Unforgivable only on Netflix.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to the Netflix Film Club channel to get our latest exclusive videos. Plus, hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.